You are welcome to this episode, Introduction to Practical Quail Production and Management. Introduction. Quail farming is considered a very promising micro-poultry investment. Quail farming is an uncommon farming business in Nigeria. It requires little capital, equipment, space and labor, and provides an inexpensive, readily available and high-quality meat and eggs. Although quail farming contributes to the alleviation of protein deficiency in diets of people in developing countries, as they have been largely neglected as a livestock species due to its size, their contribution to healthy food production have been greatly ignored and or underestimated. There is little knowledge on their production, medical value, marketing, and consumption under smallholder conditions. Therefore, quail farming should be encouraged with a special focus on the traditional subsistence rearing system as practiced by limited resource farmers. The business of quail farming in Nigeria is now growing at a feverish pitch, attracting entrepreneurs. Some use it as complementary business, or to some is a main sustainable revenue stream. Quail farming may well be a key wealth creation engagement to consider in the country. Few people have embraced quail farming are not only smiling to banks, they are enjoying both the nutritional and health values derived from consuming it. The high rate of returns and low cost of investment, as well as rearing them, are some of the reasons many farmers are fast resorting to quail farming. A mature chicken hen consumes on average of 150 grams of feed per day and requires regular administration of drugs, while quail eats 20 grams of feed per day and hardly requires any drug. Quail is a collective name of several genera of mid-sized birds generally considered in the order Galliformes. They belong to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata, class Aves, orders Galliformes. And the genus could be either Cotinix, Anurophasis, Pedicula, or Sia. Example from different genera. Under the genus Cotinix, you have the common quail, which is Cotinix cotinix, Japanese quail, Cotinix japonica, stubble quail, Cotinix pectoralis, and so on. Under genus Anurophasis, you have snow mountain quail. Under genus Pedicula, you have jungle bush quail, Pedicula asiatica, and so on. And under genus Oryssia, you have Himalayan quail, Oryphasia supercilosa. There are more than 45 species of quail. Although Japanese quail is the largest species and it is much smaller than a pigeon. Unlike chicken, there is no such thing as quail breeds. Instead, quail can be divided into various genera. Differences between different types of quail. You have the Asian blue quail, for example, is Cotinix chinensis. It's also known as button quail, the smallest of all these quail species. You have blue quail, Cotinix adansoni. It's commonly found throughout the sub-Saharan Africa. You have brown quail, which is also known as swamp quail, which is commonly found throughout wet areas of Australia. Others include common quail, Algonquin quail, Himalayan quail, and those ones, they are a rare genus found only in the Himalayan mountain regions. Japanese quail, which is Cotinix japonica, is from Asia. It is now raised around the world, used for both eggs and quail meat. Jungle bush quail, they are found throughout South Asia and is rarely raised. You also have others like New Zealand quail, rock bush quail, which is rarely raised for eggs or meat, mountain snow quail, stubble quail, and so on. But our focus will be on the Japanese quail. because it is mostly found throughout the world and is of economic value. Therefore, Japanese quail is gaining economic relevance around here because of its accrued egg medicinal properties. Japanese quail, also known as Cotonese quail, or Faroe quail, or Stubble quail, and Eastern quail, differ from the North American bobwhite quails. Japanese quails are hardy birds that thrive in a small cage and are inexpensive to keep. They are fairly disease resistant, and their life expectancy is about 2 or 2.5 years. If the bird has not been subject to genetic selection for body weight, the adult male quail will weigh about 100 to 140 grams, while the female are slightly heavier, weighing around 120 to 160 grams. The female are characterized by light tan feathers with black speckings on the throat and upper breast. The male have rusty brown throat and breast feathers. Male also have a cloacal gland, a bulbous, large glandular structure on the upper edge of the vent that secretes a white foamy material. The unique gland can be used to assess the reproductive performance of the males. Japanese quail may start to lay egg as early as 35 days of age under proper conditions with proper care, and could lay approximately 200 to 300 eggs in a year, although fertility in breeder flock is higher between 2 to 8 months of age. Japanese quail eggs are mottled brown color and are often covered with light blue chalky materials. Some strains lay only white eggs. The average weight of the egg is about 10 grams, about 8% of the body weight of the quail hen. Young chicks weigh about 6 to 7 grams when hatched and are brownish with yellow specks, and their shells are fragile. Japanese quail can be sexed as early as 3 weeks of age based on the feather color, which is distinct for male and female of species. They reach sexual maturity at about 5 to 6 weeks of age. Male generally live longer than the female and have characteristic crown known as Cotton X. If you want to start the farm or you want to start the enterprise, you must be careful for your foundation stock, the first stock. You have to select a good stock, and the first thing we are going to look at. For beginners, you can start with quail pullet of about 30 to 35 days old. Some of the pointers in selecting good quail are: you have to look at the body conformation. The feathers need to be tidy and neat, and you must afford buying those with streak of white or black feathers because those are signs of inbreeding. Choose birds with uniform size. A mature 60-day-old Japanese quail will have an average weight of 120 grams. However, at age 30 to 35 days old, they weigh only 100 grams. You have to check the record of the parent stock, especially on the egg size, laying efficiency, which should be around 65%. You have to look at the growth rate or body weight. After selecting the stock, you have to know the size of the flock that you want. The size of the initial stock totally depends on the financial capacity of the person. However, it is not advisable to start big. Quails are not easy to raise, and a beginner should first get necessary experience before going to large scale. Quails multiply rapidly, and therefore expansion will not be a problem. A beginner can start with 10 to 15 pullets. Management. Under management, the first thing we are going to look at is the housing and equipment. Since one of the advantages in quail raising is the relatively small space that is required, commensurately, the cost of putting up a cage is less, and the materials commonly used in making quail cages are plywood, 1/4 inch mesh wire, 1x1 lumber to serve as the frame. But this does not mean that innovative use of metallic or galvanized mesh constructions and local materials or a combination is not possible. For every stage in quail's life, space varies. This is true as the case of other fowls and other livestock. So the following will help to guide a farmer. Like at the chick stage, which is between day 1 to 15, the bird could need about 2.5 by 2.5 inch space for Japanese quail. Growing stage between 16 to 35 days, maybe increase to 3 inches. Laying stage up to 36 days and so on will be more than 3. Since quails are not efficient feed converter, they should not be raised for broiler production. Layer cages should not be too high, preferably about 5 feet in some cases, or around 5 inches. Height can accommodate the Japanese quail. Providing too much will encourage them to fly, and that will come with injuries. Brooding and brooding management. Temperature during the first 5 days after hatch is around 95 degrees Fahrenheit, which may be reduced to 90 degrees Fahrenheit on the 6th day and down to 85 on the 10th day, after which the quail will have developed enough feathers to keep themselves warm. To ensure better circulation of air in the brooding box, air vents should be provided. Use clean clothes or sack or newspapers to spread over the screen portion of the brooder, especially during the first 10 days. This will help conserve the heat in the brooder. 5 or 6 layers of clean, dry newspaper can be used to cover the wire mesh for the first 10 days, so that as the first paper is spoiled, then you remove it, then it will come on the clean one. Water in drinking fountain should be changed daily, and care must be exercised to avoid spilling of water over the paper to prevent unnecessary dampness. Gas lamp or electric bulb may be used to control the temperature inside the brooder. The brooder box must be cat and rat proof, with proper feed, enough water, and optimum temperature. The mortality of quail can be kept at around 5 to 8% during the brooding stage, which usually lasts up to 15 days. Rearing management. After the 15th day, the birds are transferred to growing cages. During the growing stage, it is not advisable to expose the bird to more than 12 hours of light. Only birds which are healthy and with uniform size should be transferred to growing cages. The smaller ones should be disposed. The average mortality from the start of the growing period up to 35 days is around 1 to 4%. And on the 35th day, the male birds are already discernible by the dark brown color of the breast feather. At this stage, female can be segregated and transferred to the laying cages. During the 25th day fattening period, light should be restricted to around 6 to 8 hours a day. This practice will improve the quality of meat. Layer management. On the average, quail will start laying after 45 days post-hatching, and in some cases is around 35 days. The production cycle can last for 300 to 320 days, and within this period, the laying efficiency should be maintained at around 65%. Some of the major considerations when managing layers are the feed, which will be discussed separately. Water, that's number 2. Fresh water should be provided, and the water should also be clean. Well, number 3, culling. In some large scale operations, it is advisable that massive culling be done regularly for birds that have physical deformities, have grown fat, or are sick or are not laying. Those birds should be culled out of the group. This latter condition is manifested by the size of the vent and conformation of the abdominal parts. To know a bird that is laying, you look at the size of the vent and conformation of the abdominal parts. The last one is the removal of waste. Because of high protein content of the quail feed, quail dropping has high ammonia content, which will cause discomfort of the birds if not removed daily. So removal of the manure cap can facilitate by placing a manure receptacle or receiver under the cage. Another thing you have to consider here is the light. Lighting quail may be given extra light up to midnight. The yucca birds in the group will have enough time to eat after the dominant ones have taken their share. If there is an intention of producing fertile eggs for future replacement, the male should be kept in a separate cage and should only be mixed with the females at the time the fertile eggs are to be produced at the ratio of 1 to 6 or 1 to 3 for Japanese or American breeds respectively. Quail birds are very sensitive to high salt level in the feeds. The optimum level of the mineral should be kept around 7%, and in some cases, and in no case should be more than 1%. Feeding management. The major cause of failure in raising quail is the faulty feeding practice employed by farmers. Most of our quail raisers today feed commercial chicken feeds to quail. This is an erroneous practice and it should be corrected. The protein requirements of chicken and quail are different, and as such, the use of chicken feed in quail raising is not advisable. Below is the comparison of the crude protein requirement of quail. At the chick stage, quail will require about 28% crude protein, while chicken will require around 21%. At the crowd stage, the quail will require 24%, while the chicken will require 16%. At the layer stage, the quail will require 26%, while a chicken will require 15%. From the above information, we can clearly see the marked difference in the primary requirement of both birds. Quail cannot survive on chicken feeds for a long time. If ever they will survive, the mortality rate will be very high, sometimes reaching up to 70% from day old to 45 days. Another disadvantage of feeding chicken mash to quail is the very occurrence of molting, which affects severely the egg production. The claim that mixing quail feed with high protein is expensive and not economical is baseless. The advantage of giving the right ratio far overweighs the cost of giving chicken feeds. This advantage can be summarized below. Mortality rate can be kept low with good and appropriate feed. From day 1 to day 15, it could be around 5 to 8%. From 16 to 35 days, it could be around 1 to 4%. And from day 36 to around 360 days, it should not be more than 8 to 12%. Production. The laying efficiency can be easily maintained within the average range of 63 to 68% for a period of 300 to 320 days. It is not rare to get laying percentage of 80%. Eggs are bigger and more nutritious. For breeders, fertility and hatchability are high. These things, when quantified and taken together, would positively refute the claim of feeding quail with high protein content as required here is costly and non-economical. The feed consumption of quail at different stages are: at the chick stage, they will take 7 grams per day. Growing stage, a Japanese quail will take 17 grams per day. At laying stage, they will take around 23 grams per day. During the first 15 days, the feed of the birds should be grounded into a fineness enough to pass through ordinary window screen. Like chicken, quails are affected by abrupt changes in feeding. Hence, it is not advisable to change feed abruptly. Breeding tips. Research indicated that grouping a single male with 2 or 3 females will generally have high fertility. The mating ratio should be around 1:3 or 1:6. Fertility decreases markedly in older birds, and inbreeding is not advisable because it increases the incidence of abnormalities and this can greatly reduce reproductive performance. Yet there are some reasons for poor hatch. Maybe that the eggs are infertile. 2. The eggs may have cracked and the contents drain out. 3. Eggs are too old when set, because when you have an egg, it must not stay under room temperature more than 7 days. Eggs are held in extreme temperatures prior to incubation. This can cause poor hatch. Number 5. Shells are contaminated. Eggs are not turned often enough. Temperatures is too high or too low or too variable. Too little humidity or too much humidity in the incubator. And number 9, improper ventilation. Marketing. Eggs could be marketed when placed in a basket, marketed fresh, or placed in box cartons. They should be stored in air condition for a period of 7 days at maximum. You can market the broilers, which are the males, because they have a feed conversion ratio of around 3 to 1. This poor feed conversion efficiency makes a broiler production uneconomical, and therefore any broiler produced should be treated secondly in a quail raising or quail farming. The broilers refer to the male that are bred for meat. The procedure in dressing quail is the same as in chicken. When you want to market, so you dress the broilers, you bleed them, you scald in hot water, and you remove the feathers, you eviscerate. And in marketing, prices are also important. Broiler are more tender than cod layers. As such, a former are sold at high price. The selling price of this should be based on the cost of production. A day old to 60 plus the dressing, storage, and related selling costs. Quail production. You can calculate the cost of production of 100 quails. The income can be computed as 70 eggs per day times the price of egg. And a crate of quail egg is costlier than a crate of chicken egg. It could cost the housing equipment, which can vary on a depreciation. Other sources of income could include the male, the feather, the fecal samples, or the litter rather. You have quail delicacies, quail breast, quail legs. They may be fried, they may be roasted, they may be marinated. They are forms of culinary preparations. The egg are tastier. It's good for banquets. They could be used for decorating. They could be spiced. They are good as appetizers and good snacks. What are the health benefits of quail eggs? Quail eggs are very good natural cure for treating many diseases in preventive and therapeutic use. Japanese quail eggs regenerate the body. They stimulate growth, combat stress, obesity, asthma, hypertension, diabetes, kidney, and liver diseases, and this has been substantiated by various researches. Also, consumption of quail egg is of great natural cure for cough and ulcer. A special feature of quail eggs is that it is a good natural agent for fighting with hair loss and osteoporosis. Quail egg also purifies the body, they normalize blood pressure, and increase hemoglobin. Other health benefits include that it can dissolve kidney stones. Research scientists have shown that quail meat and egg can help avoid adverse effects of stress and overwork. Even in children, they enhance development, both physically and mentally. A child eats 2 eggs per day, has better memory, strong nervous system, sharp vision, better development, less sick, and it's no wonder a Japanese student eats 2 quail eggs per day. They give good results in treating infertility. They increase sexual potency and cause slow, rapid ejaculation in men. Also, quail eggs makes a woman feel better during pregnancy and helps the amount of milk produced in nursing mothers. If you compare the egg cholesterol, chicken has about 201 milligram, duck has a cholesterol of about 621. Turkey has about 747 milligram, and one goose egg has a cholesterol of about 1,226 milligram. But quail eggs has about 76 milligram, which shows that quail has low cholesterol. Looking at the summary advantage of quail keeping, they require minimum space, low capital. Quails are comparative study birds. It can be marketed at an early age. Around 5 weeks, they will start laying. They have early sexual maturity, a high rate of egg laying, up to 280 to 300 eggs per year. Quail meat is tastier than chicken, has less fat content. It promotes body and brain development in children. Naturally, quail eggs are on the par with that of children. Moreover, they contain less cholesterol. Quail meat and egg are a nutritious diet for pregnant mothers. Highly age limit survival of about 2.5 to 3 years. They require very little amount of food in a day compared to chicken. I want to appreciate the sources I consulted. Thank you for listening.